take cooking real seriously now. When I got into this 44 years ago, we were just a bunch of kids that wanted to be part of a party. Sort of took a while to figure out that we were actually working the party. But, you know, so I don't take what I do very seriously. So if anybody has a joke, we'd like to start this with a joke. I think, Kevin, you have a joke? Oh, it's his birthday. Oh, so stand up, Kevin Kramer. Please stand up. Here we go. Let's hear the joke. And then we can get rolling. Okay, it's got to be loud. Turn around. You got to yell. I'm not going to repeat it. Turn around. Kevin's embarrassed. Here we go. The lamb. The lamb. Come on. We got to go. You said you had a minute. Loud.
Here we go.
Here we go.
No pressure. I'm not from this area. I'm from the Midwest. But I'm from Ohio.
You're down to 45
anyway,
seconds.
I understand that. Okay. Salesman's going through town. He goes up on the other side of the mountain. He's up around Temecula. And you know what that can look like? You know, it's very barren up there, a lot of rocks, things like that. And he kind of got lost. He really wanted to get to L.A., didn't know where he was going. And he said, you got, there's no gas stations here. There's nothing up there. He said, so, you know, he's looking along the side of the road to see if he could find a pickup truck stop there or a man. And he notices that there's going up one hill. There's this ranch, it looked like, a small ranch. There was a shepherd there because he had a herd of sheep. So he said, I'm going to go up and ask this guy just how I get to L.A. And he pulls into the driveway, long winding road that goes up, says, as he's going up the driveway, he looks on the other side of the road and sees that there's a man there in a little pasture, and he's making love to a sheep. And the guy said, well, what the heck? This is screwy territory here. He goes up to where the shepherd is. And he pulls over, walks out. It's a young man, about 18 years old. He said, fella, I'm lost. I want to get to L.A. He said, that's no problem. I can tell you how to get there. After he told him how to get there, he said, by the way, I'm coming up your driveway, and there's a guy on the other side of the street screwing a sheep. And he said, oh, that's my dad.
Okay. Here we go. Yeah, it was Kevin's birthday. This is going to get fast and furious, so fasten your seatbelts because it might get confusing and I might get confused. So what we're going to do today are stocks, sauces, and soups, and they're all basically based on the stock. A stock's really easy to make. It's making chicken soup. So what you do is take some fresh herbs, thyme, tarragon, some basil, living basil, throw it in a pot with a carrot. You don't have to peel it. A whole onion. Don't have to peel it. Make it two carrots. Two ribs of celery. Some chicken bones. So if you go to the market and you get some chicken breasts, you ask them to bone it for you, you want the bones. Okay? Some parsley. And whole black peppercorns. Just a few. No laughing. Some bay leaves. Cover it with water. Bring it to a boil. And then pull it down to a simmer and let it cook on a low heat for 4 to 8 hours. Okay, after 4 to 8 hours, you have a broth. Now, what I do with that broth at that point, you can work with it, make a soup, or you can take it and reduce it, and you reduce it by 60%, and it gets to the consistency of this and this color, this is chicken stock that's been reduced. That's called demi-glace. Yes. I'm a lazy cook. What I do is I cook it, and yet the proper way is to skim it off, but you don't have to, because after you strain it, you can put it in the refrigerator. It will congeal, and it's better that way. You can just pull it off with your hand. Exactly. Okay. Any other questions? So that's demi-glace and stock. Now, how do you make what do you do with it after that? I'm going to make a soup, but before I make the soup, I'm going to start two reductions for two sauces. I got to move faster because I want to tell my jokes, and mine aren't as long as Kevin's. Okay, so they can be. That's where you had to sign the waiver. So what I'm going to do is make a butter sauce and then a sauce based on the demi-glace. And then a vegan sauce, I guess. Okay, so the butter sauce is beurre blanc. Beurre blanc is, these first two sauces are reduction sauces. So beurre blanc is two parts white wine to one part white wine vinegar. This is about the only thing that I measure out. So I only have two pots here to simulate four sauces. So I'm going to just talk my way through this. I'm going to take 2 cups of white wine, 1 cup of white wine vinegar, a good handful of shallots, and when I'm going to put it in a pot, put it on high heat, and reduce it down to this much. Okay? Likewise, I'm going to make a sherry vinegar sauce. I'm going to do the same thing, but no white wine, just sherry vinegar. I'm going to reduce it. I'm going to take 2 to 4 cups of sherry vinegar. I'm going to reduce it, and then reduce it all the way down to that. By reduce, I mean boil it down. Boil away the liquid. Okay? This is what I have. Now, for this particular sauce, I'm going to add demi-glace to it. Okay? So you've cooked it down. I'm going to add some demi-glace. Now, the demi-glace you can take, or the stock, you can take and freeze it and pull it out as you need it. Okay? It will not last indefinitely in your refrigerator. Okay, so now I'm going to cook this and further reduce the demi-glace. Now, you don't want to reduce it too far because it gets real pasty and it gets real thick. I like my sauces to be real light so that at the end of the meal, you don't feel like your liver has to process all of this. It's like you should feel good after you're done eating, not like I feel sick. Okay. Any questions on these two sauces? So the beurre blanc, we've reduced. I'm going to add a touch of heavy cream. Okay. And then the last thing I'm going to do, once it's heated up, I'm going to add some cold butter to it, and it is essential that the butter is cold. It cannot be hot. Okay? Now I'm going to talk about soups. And to do soups and do them easily, I'm fortunate that I live in a city that produces probably the best blender that is out there in the world. It's called a Vitamix. Okay? This This saves you so much time. Because normally in the old days, we would make a soup, then we would puree it, and then we would take it and put it through a screen. It's called passing it, so that it would be perfectly smooth. Well, this does all that without passing it because the thing's so strong. It's probably the best one on the market. Okay, so we've got, I'm going to make a butternut squash soup. We probably could start sending out. Do the butternut squash if we could first. I'm going to saute some onions and add some garlic. And I've had to do this earlier just so that you could see how I finish it. I sauteed some onions and garlic. I added with this machine, the beauty of this machine is I could take whole herbs just like this without cleaning them. Put it, just dump it in there. Okay? I could put whole cloves of garlic in there. I saute the onions, saute some butternut squash, peeled butternut squash. And then I cover it with some stock. Okay, so the question is, how long do you cook this for? So obviously you've got to cook it, or maybe not obviously, you've got to cook it until the squash is fully cooked. But at the same time, you've got to know how long to cook it so that it's not paste, which most people will make that mistake and cook it too long and it'll be too thick and it'll be like over-reducing a sauce. Or they'll cook it too short and it's not going to be, it's going to be too runny. So I'm going to start cooking this. Any questions? Don't be shy. Yes, miss. No. Well, for purposes of this demo, I started the soup. So, I mean, we're going from there because you can't do this soup in a half an hour. Please turn that phone off. Okay, so I'm going to start cooking this soup. Okay, if you can also see that this beurre blanc reduction is starting to get hot. Now, the other soup that I'm going to do is gazpacho. Okay, with this machine, it takes longer to actually cut up the vegetables than it does to actually puree it. Okay, so this is cucumbers, jalapeno, onions, red pepper, green pepper, cilantro, and olive oil, and a little garlic. And then I might add a little tomato juice just to make it so that it blends easily. Pardon? It is all raw. Okay, pretty much done. Yes. Yes. Good question. I'm going to add some Zach Brill extra virgin olive oil. Very good. Thank you. Cleveland, Ohio.
Is it really
virgin? Okay. at Heinen's in Cleveland, Ohio, or if you're not as far east as Cleveland, you can stop in Chicago and you can buy it at a Heinen's there. A little lime juice, which I don't have here, but instead of the lime juice, if you want, you could use the Zach Brule balsamic vinegar, which this stuff is incredible. Just a great joke earlier. Okay, so that's done. That is it. Any questions on this? So you can see what the consistency of this is. It's liquid. You do it in a blender and then you force it through a sieve. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do, can't clean this out. So I'm going to do a red pepper sauce. What I've done is I've taken some red peppers, yes, and I grilled them and then peeled the skins off. I also took some red onions and grilled those. Some extra virgin olive oil. And some balsamic vinegar. And then I'm going to add some salt and pepper to it. There also was some garlic that I grilled. And if you want to add a little spice to this, you can add a grilled jalapeno. From what I was told earlier, people in California like things spicy. Okay, so you can see the consistency of this. This machine is pretty much idiot proof. Okay. I cleaned it last night. I just put some water in it and then turned it on. Yeah, I'm sure she needs it clean. That'll drive her crazy if it's not clean. Okay. So this soup is pretty much the consistency it needs to be. Okay, sorry about this. Got to figure out how to work this stuff. The other thing I want to mention here today is this isn't just us, these chefs, that are executing this whole event. There's a bunch of people backstage here that are making this possible. I'd like to bring them out. I don't know if they can come out. He's over there. But you've got Bill and Dave Locke that they're the ones that have made this possible. And I know I'm not the easiest person to work with because, unfortunately, I don't really follow recipes. So everybody's sort of gripping when it's the last moment and I don't know what I'm doing. And then on top of that, I have to come up with a recipe. Okay, so we're going to finish the beurre blanc. Okay, I just added some cold butter to this. I added some cold butter to this. I'm going to whisk this in. Yes. Okay, so the last thing I'm going to do is puree this soup. And this is something that, since I'm old, back in the old days, I'm the old one. In the old days, this process would take an hour to do, okay, to do it right. Now, one of the things that I'm going to do here is, I don't have any butter out here, but they have a process. Was anybody at any of these demos that I did last year? They have this process that they call mounting. You mount something with butter. And it actually enriches the dish and will also, this is serious stuff, it will also thicken it. Now, unfortunately, this isn't clean, but here's how you do this. Now, if you noticed, I didn't talk about this. I did not salt and pepper the stock, and I did not salt and pepper the demi-glace. The last thing that you do is that. I like to use salt. But you're all right. You're safe. So if this wasn't the consistency that I wanted it to be, the easiest way for me to thicken it would be, number one, I could put it back out on the burner. But since I'm lazy, I could take cold butter and add it to it. But I think we actually just, from looking at this, it's done. It's the consistency I want it to be. It's not too runny, and it's not too thick. Now we gave you a sample here of these sauces, so you get an idea of what they taste like. Now, they've been sitting probably for a half an hour, so they're not going to be warm, number one. Number two, they're going to be a little thicker than what they should be because they've cooled down. Any questions? There's ricotta cheese on this bread with a spread of butternut squash puree. You've got the red pepper sauce, the sherry vinegar sauce, and the beurre blanc. These are all the sauces that we made here now. Is anybody a government worker? Are there any government workers here? Okay, so there aren't any. I don't want to offend anybody. So this guy goes to a job interview at the Postal Service, and the supervisor that interviews him goes, do you have any allergies? It's like, no, I don't have any. I'm allergic to caffeine, that's it. It's like, okay. It's like, do you have any disabilities? Well, I was in Afghanistan, and I was in an explosion, and I lost my testicles. It's like, well, that's all right. It's like, you're fine. It's like, you're hired. It's like, here's the deal. We start out on Monday. We start at 8 o'clock and go to 4 o'clock, but you could show up at 10 o'clock. It's like, why do I show up at 10 o'clock after you guys are showing up at 8? It's like, well, all we do for the first 2 hours is sit around, drink coffee, and scratch our nuts. Sorry. Any question about food? Any questions about the Vitamix? The Vitamix is indispensable. This cooktop is incredible. I've been fortunate that I'm working with two tricked out pieces of equipment here. This is really good. Yes. Mark DeMille. Mark DeMille, this is beautiful kitchen here. He can design your kitchen too. Okay, last one. Uh-oh. It's not going to be a blonde joke. Sorry, Denise, don't worry. A friend of mine was my college roommate. He was a comedian. So he was also a lawyer. And he would come on stage, and his whole thing was that he was Denver's funniest lawyer. So he cut, don't shake your head, Kyle, and bow it down. It's going to be all right. So he said, I saw that he would come on stage, and he would say, these young comedians backstage are always asking me for legal advice. It's like, one of them wanted to know what the difference between jail and prison was. It's like, he said, jail's where you go when you get caught doing something you're not supposed to do. Prison's where you go when you've been convicted of that crime. And he hesitated and said, it's like a lot like engagement and marriage. Except there's more sex in prison. Thank you for indulging me. Any other questions? Yes. If you want to come up and look at these sauces. There's a long-legged blonde over here that you need to talk to about that. But in the past we were selling it here. The vinegars are incredible. We're not this year. By the time we got it out here, it's just shipping it all. But these are incredible products. Any other questions? Bill? The bottle. Oh. I cook with wine. Sometimes they even add it to the food. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Zach.